Hello everyone, in this video we are going to talk about the project that we have implemented, that is the density based traffic control system with the help of Raspberry Pi microcontroller. As you know, we are living in the 21st century era in which using the vehicles has become the necessity of time, as it reduces the time and efforts required by the human beings to travel from one point to another. But as you know, as the number of vehicles increase, the traffic also increases, which causes a lot of issues and it consumes a lot of time. And in this way, the traffic signals come into picture. The traffic signals are there to dictate the drivers the way in which the signals are to be maintained or the traffic rules that have to be followed in order to reduce the accident, in order to maintain the traffic under control. But as you know, since the old time, these traffic signals are located in the highly residential areas or squares. But still the problem of the traffic has continued to rise over time. So in order to tackle this problem, we have came with the idea of automated traffic control system. Our system is relevant to the actual situation in various manners. Of course, the primary drive of our system is to control, regulate and guide the traffic. Also, our system will be useful to continuously monitor the amount of traffic in highly residential areas such as school areas, office areas, etc. Also, we are going to update the websites that we are going to provide with the amount of traffic that is available in the various areas, so that the users are able to see which area is highly crowded and which area is less crowded, so that they can decide the routes that they are going to take accordingly. One more issue with the high traffic areas is that the amount of accidents in those areas is high. So our system can be useful to protect human life by providing the safest routes as well. Now let's talk about the top level design of our system. As mentioned before, we are going to use Raspberry Pi 3B as the processing unit. As the Raspberry Pi is one of the most advanced processors available, it is also compatible with the camera module, and with the help of Raspberry Pi, we can also connect to our website so that we can update the information on our website. As a camera unit, we are going to use the Pi Cam sensor in order to capture the cameras. Then via this camera sensor, the captured images are sent to the processor, and the processing is done over the processor and the required actions are taken place. We will discuss the detailed working of our system furthermore. Now let us talk about the detailed design of our system. We are going to use the camera module in the space of input device in our system. Via this camera module, the current traffic situation in the given area is captured with this camera module. This captured image is processed with the help of image processing algorithms that we'll be discussing further. With the help of these image processing algorithms, the ages of the vehicles is determined, and with the help of these ages, the density of the vehicles is determined. For reference, we have given a certain image that is already stored in the processor. This image is considered as moderate traffic. If the density captured via the image is higher than the reference image, then the traffic is considered as high. And if the density in the captured image is less than that of the reference image, then the traffic is considered as less. According to this situation, the higher traffic or lower traffic response is given by the system, and the corresponding information is updated on the website. As well as on that particular location, we'll be providing three lights: red light, green light and yellow light. The yellow light would be on when the traffic is moderate, that is, the traffic is considerable regarding the reference light. If the traffic is way higher compared to the reference image, that means the red light will turn on, which will indicate the vehicles that the traffic in that particular area is high, and the vehicles and the drivers will be able to take a different route to reach their destination. And if the traffic is low, then the green light will be turned on, which will indicate that the route is available to travel safely. So in this way, the system will tell the drivers which is the best possible route for them to reach their destination. Now, let's talk about the tools and technologies that we have used to implement this project. We have used Raspberry Pi 3 as the main processor of this project. We have used LEDs as an indicator to demonstrate red, green and yellow light. We have used camera module PiCam in order to capture the images. And in order to program our Raspberry Pi, we have used Python 3. We have created a local web server in order to update the information regarding the traffic control system. Now, comparing the image is not an easy task. After capturing the image, there are several image processing algorithms that have to be processed in order to gain the proper image. The first algorithm is noise reduction algorithm. Usually, the edge detection algorithms follow the gradient operation, and the gradient operation is very susceptible to noise. Even a smallest change in the noise can alter the edges to a large extent. Hence, noise reduction algorithms is followed. Second is gradient calculation algorithm. With the help of gradient calculation, we can detect the intense edges by calculating the gradient of the image using edge detection operators. Then the next one is non-maximum suppression. Ideally, we want the final image to have sharp edges. Thus, we must perform non-maximum suppression operation. The principle behind this algorithm is very simple. We find the pixels with the maximum values in each direction. Then the next one is double threshold. The double threshold step involves identifying three different kinds of pixels: the strong pixels, weak pixels, and non-relevant pixels. Strong pixels are those pixels that have intensity which is very high so that they can contribute to the edges. Weak pixels have very low intensity, hence they do not actually contribute to the image edge of the image, and all the other pixel values are called as non-relevant pixels. Then edge tracing by hysteresis is the next algorithm that we have used. Based on the threshold values, the hysteresis consists of transforming weak pixel into strong ones so that the proper edges can be found out. Before deploying any system, testing and verification of the system is very important. Hence, in order to test our system, we have came up with the following test cases. The first test case is to check if the images are being captured properly, because as the traffic moves continuously, the images need to be captured continuously. The second test case is check that according to the comparison, the proper comparison is being done. As image processing takes time, the comparison has to be done within time in order to give the proper indication. Then the third test case is check proper indication instruction are to be given by the system or not. If the system is giving proper indication according to the level of traffic in the given area, that means the system is working properly. Now let's talk about some of the advantages and limitations of our system. The major advantage of our system is that it reduces the frequency of an accident in some high traffic areas. It provides automatic instructions without any human interference. As there is no requirement of human anywhere, we can reduce the amount of traffic police that are required in different areas, and we can use that manpower in some other areas. This system also provides the authority to the drivers to move with confidence, as they know that in certain area the traffic is less, so that they can drive the car with the speed that is permitted in that area. It reduces the economical requirements as the system is not that much expensive. The traffic prediction and control can be done with the help of this system, with the help of the data that is captured with the help of camera sensor. We can identify the density in particular area, and the traffic prediction can be done very easily. But also there are certain limitations that come with our system.
the major limitation that is the error with the capturing of the images because of the weathering condition. In times of rainy seasons or some areas where there is snow, the proper images cannot be captured with the help of cameras, and hence the comparison becomes difficult. Second big limitation is the processing time that is required to process the given images. This takes time. If the processing is much larger, then there is a delay in giving the proper indication to the system. Now let's talk about the simulation of our actual project. Because of the unavailability of the hardware, we went with the simulation, and as we didn't have any camera in this case, we provided both the reference image and the captured image. As you can see, the reference image is on the right, which shows the moderate traffic in an area. The captured area is having more amount of vehicles in that image. As you can see, with the help of edge detection algorithm, we have detected the edges of the vehicle, which gives us idea of what would be the moderate traffic in the right side image. And in the left side image, we can see that because of the heavy traffic, the more number of edges are detected, and because of this, this particular road is having higher amount of traffic, and hence the red light will turn on and the drivers will know that they cannot use this route and they can choose the other route for their traveling, and in this way our system will execute. Now let's talk about the project challenges that we face. As mentioned before, one of the major challenges that we face is the obstruction to the camera due to the weathering conditions. To overcome this, what we can do is provide multiple camera sensors so that if one of the cameras is unable to detect the traffic, we can take the use of another camera. Another major issue is the delay in the image processing time. This is just a basic system that we have proposed. In the future, a lot of features can be added to this system. One of the major features that can be added is to check if the drivers are actually following the traffic rules or not. We can see if the vehicles are traveling according to the speed limit and they are following the proper traffic signals or not. Another major thing that we can do in the future is to predict the best route available with minimum traffic. We can, with the help of our website's data, we can see the amount of traffic around a particular area, and according to that, on the website we can predict what is the best route to travel from one point to another with where there is minimum amount of traffic. One more thing that we can do is to add the fine to those people that break the laws. That is all we have regarding our density based traffic control system. Thank you so much for watching, and if you have any queries, please feel free to contact us.